Today we're discussing J.J. Thomson's discovery of electrons and how Millikan used that knowledge to conduct his oil drop experiment to test the charge of electrons. Let's get started. In 1897, J.J. Thomson discovered the electron and measured its charge to mass ratio using the cathode ray tube experiment. Thomson and others tried to measure the charge of an electron using clouds of charged water droplets. They observed how fast the water droplets fell under the influence of gravity and an electric field. In 1909, Robert Millikan began experiments to determine the charge of an individual water droplet rather than measuring the whole cloud of water, but found that droplets of water evaporated too quickly for accurate measurement. He then asked one of his graduate students, Harvey Fletcher, to find a material that would evaporate more slowly. Fletcher found that droplets of oil dispersed by a simple perfume atomizer injected into an air-filled chamber would pick up the charge from the ionized air. Through a microscope, the droplets were observed while an electric field was applied to the upper and lower plates of the chamber. By measuring the time and velocity for the droplets to fall or rise, and applying Thomson's charge to mass ratio into an equation, Millikan could calculate the charge on the drop and therefore the charge of each electron in that drop. Millikan won the Nobel Prize in 1923 for this work, as well as the determination of the value of Planck's constant in 1916. The top portion is a canister with a small hole that the experimenter can spray the oil through. The oil will pick up a small charge as it comes through the atomizer. The very bottom portion of the top canister has an even smaller hole that allows the oil droplets to fall through. Looking through the eyepiece, you'll see the white oil droplets against the blue background. Differences in the size of the oil droplets means that some will fall faster than others. Be sure to focus the eyepiece of the microscope so you can visualize the droplets easily. The two plates contained in the bottom chamber are attached to a variable electric generator that can be controlled by turning the dial. The air in the lower chamber is charged by the attached ionizer. You can control the charge of the lower plates by flipping the switch. Experiment with changing the intensity of the electric field being applied to the two plates. Increasing the field strength can slow the rate of the droplets, reverse the direction of the droplets, and cause some of the oil droplets to float. The current being applied to the floating droplets is the electric potential difference, which counteracts the influence of gravity. Millikan used this value to calculate the charge on the electrons in the oil droplets. So that's the Millikan oil drop experiment. Thanks for checking out this video, and be sure to check out all our other experiments. Also, follow us on social media at the links below and stay up to date with all of our videos. See you next time.